Now we'll take a look at two basic examples of compound inequalities. Compound inequalities are two or more inequalities connected with the words and or. In our first example, notice how this looks like two inequalities squished together. This is an example of two inequalities connected by and. So if we start in the middle of this inequality with the variable, we can read this from left to right. We can also read this from right to left. So in blue, we can see x is less than or equal to 7. And in red, from right to left, we would read this x is greater than negative 5. And because of the word and, the solution will be all the values that satisfy both of these inequalities. For example, if your boss says you'll get a raise if you show up on time every day and complete all of your work, that means you'd have to complete both tasks to get a raise. So what we're going to do is graph both of these inequalities on the same number line and then determine graphically where they're both true. So to graph x is greater than negative 5, we'd have an open point on negative 5 and an arrow to the right because it says greater than negative 5. And x also has to be less than or equal to 7. And because this interval does include 7, we'd make a closed point on 7. And then for numbers less than 7, we'd have an arrow to the left. Now this is not the graph of our solution. We need to interpret this. We want to determine which interval satisfies both inequalities, or which numbers have been graphed twice, both in blue and in red. And you can see it would be all the numbers from negative 5 to positive 7, not including negative 5, but including 7. So to show this, we'll adjust our graph to look like this. Again, it does not include positive 5, but it does include positive 7, and then all the numbers between these two. Therefore, in interval notation, we'd have the interval from negative 5 to 7. It does not include negative 5, so we have an open parenthesis here, but it does include 7, so we make a square bracket here. In the second example, it's a lot more obvious that this is an OR because it's written as an OR. So if we have two inequalities connected by OR, that means if a number is in either interval, it satisfies the compound inequality. For example, if your boss says you'll get a raise if you show up on time every day or close a big account, if you do either of those, you'll get the raise. You do not have to satisfy both. So on this one, we can go straight to a graph. To graph x is less than or equal to negative 3, this interval does include negative 3. So we'll make a closed point on negative 3, arrow to the left, or x is greater than 7. So 7 is not in this interval, so we make an open point on 7. And then for greater than 7, we make an arrow to the right. Again, because this is an OR, either of these intervals would satisfy the compound inequality. So this is the graph of our solution, but now let's express it using interval notation. As we move left on the number line, we're approaching negative infinity. And as we move right on the number line, we'd be approaching positive infinity. And this is helpful to write the interval using interval notation. The interval on the left, we would have negative infinity and then negative 3 with a rounded parenthesis for negative infinity, but a square bracket for negative 3 because it includes negative 3. Or, in blue, we have the interval from 7 to infinity, not including 7. So we have 7 to infinity, rounded parenthesis here, as well as next to 7 to show it does not include 7. Now I should mention that instead of using the word or, sometimes you'll see textbooks use the symbol U for union, and it does mean the same thing, just so you're aware. I hope you found this helpful.